as well to deal with the fact that their opponents have so much CC in the Nautilus and the Sejuani. You can just run through that. And the final pick of the draft, the final pick of the series is a mid lane.
And Darduk is so happy to trade time with the Olaf, but he's going in too quick.
This fight is going real bad early on for TSM. Darduk already killed
Sejuani. I got true damage, but with an early kill. Okay, let's see what happens to Solo first. Mystery here.
Solo and Broken Blade into the 1v1. Nice flash coming out from Darduk there to make
sure. Once again, gets first push on the mid wave because he is Azir. Has the extra range advantage on Echo.
First, Solo has also already positioned himself behind their opponents. Santorin is going to be jumped on here. Loses a lot of HP, but the Emperor's Divide comes down. Solo coming in from the side. Power of Evil low on mana. Solo still here fighting on the front line. Broken Blade taken very low. The Haymaker not quite able to take him down. They're still chasing after Darduk. The axes are flying and Darduk is down. Flight.
Help them get there, it'll mean a lot.
It's a four-man dive that's gonna come out here in the bottom side from TSM. Ignar's the target at the start. Wild Turtle also gonna be taken down below half HP. Santorin has showed up. Looking to grab the damage onto Biofrost and finish him off. Kabe's gonna eat some damage there from the turret, but over the wall comes Power of Evil. TSM have committed. They have killed both players they came for.
Fantastic, man.
You can just walk anywhere. You can just walk anywhere on the map, and your team will not be able to get it. So it is kind of a blessing here for TSM to be able to first turret bonus on top of it, and the majority of it all going into the pockets of their hard carries to fall back on with no outer turrets remaining. So it's a really difficult.
Solo, there you go. Steals on the map. TSM looking to attack him.
Solo trying to get himself away here. 1v3 is not very good odds, even for a tanky champion, and he will be taken.
So because he's so very strong here on this Olaf, Turtle and Ignar will walk over to make sure that they can take it down to swift.
Where you take multiple melee champions. Solo actually going to get dope again.
Solo is just the target of all the TSM animosity in the world. He uses the Showstopper, but the Chain CC comes down hard and heavy, and that means Solo will be taken out without being able to get a revenge kill here yet again. TSM, they get the kill, and they manage to take the turret down too. The trade, bottom lane tier 2 turret is gone. Santorin and Power of Evil working together to take that one out. Shelly's summoned up. She's going to get another charge here onto the inhibitor turret. Power of Evil and Santorin needing a couple more auto attacks. And that kill onto Solo, that if left unattended. Right now, they're not as concerned about that as they are with taking out the remaining tier 2 here on the map. Bad spot. He uses Blade of the Ruined King to walk away without having to spend a summoner spell.
Seeing if maybe there's a chance to just start a fight off with a 6,000 gold lead, you don't feel like you always need to be waiting.
Ignar gets initiated on by Biofrost, who's going to be tanking a lot of damage there on the front line, and the Showstopper will do just... But he can't even get to the fight before they've already lost a man. Bjergsen in the back lines, trying to make a play now. Santorin goes into the stasis, the stopwatch keeping him safe, while the exhaust also made sure Bjergsen wasn't doing any real damage to anyone else. Broken Blade is still behind the pit. Solo and Santorin still marching forward. Power of Evil has decided to put it on his own shoulders to invade the enemy jungle, kill the enemy jungler, bring in the cavalry, take down Broken Blade, and he is annihilating TSM.
Oh, power.
Maybe an ability or two.
Look at how fast that Baron is dropping. Secured by...
And here they come. Baron empowered recalls give them an instant reset. FlyQuest should be able to use this Baron buff to finish off the inhibitors.
Inhibitor turret in mid lane has fallen. Solo's applying that pressure you were talking about in bottom. Inhibitor's already gone in mid. It's so easy for FlyQuest to just mow these things over. They don't seem too worried about TSM. They're still staying together, making sure the carries aren't last, and that immediately shuts down the TSM playmakers.
Uh-oh.
Biofrost now in trouble. The flash play, and Biofrost is done. It is a killing spree for Santorin. 3-0-4 here on the Olaf. 50 CS ahead of his opponent. FlyQuest in a 5v4. The inhibitor turret is the target. Darduk's going in. He has no other choice. World Ender is on for Broken Blade, and Solo's into the back line. Darduk is immediately destroyed, and FlyQuest have taken everything. The inhibitors are going. Bjergsen's going. He's just about gone. The exhaust makes it so he can barely move. The Nexus turrets will fall. TSM can do nothing but look on as FlyQuest put the finishing touches on this game, the finishing touches on this season, and the finishing touches on T.